everyone, and welcome to our newest segment of Coding with Balbette. Today, I am working on the choice script coding for Phoenix Rising. I am planning on putting this game together and getting it at least the demo up by the end of the month. I have a sort of demo up right now. It's not great, but it's certainly not the worst it could be. And I'm hoping to have the full first chapter coded and up by the end of September. So you get to join me today for a little bit of fun learning how to work with ChoiceScript. I've noticed that there aren't a lot of videos out on how ChoiceScript works, how it's used in the actual engine. As a little bit of background, there are a lot of different programs that you can use ChoiceScript with. In fact, that you can even write it in. You could even write it in Notepad++. But there's also Seaside, which is a program specifically made for it. And there's another one that I can't remember the name of right now. That's a visual interface. It works somewhat. I've tried both of those and I didn't quite like them, so I generally go with Visual Code Studio. The key thing to remember about ChoiceScript is it's mostly just writing. Like, you have these little I can't remember the exact term for them, but they're basically like little code snippets that indicate to the HTML reader. In this case, I use Chrome, but I'm testing it in the Visual Choice Studio program using the simple browser tab in here. For an example of what this looks like, let's go ahead and find one of our labels here. We're going to go up here to Fight Choice. Here we go. And so I have this set up for an alpha testing, which allows me to go to any label that I have set up just by typing in the scene name and then the label that I have worked on here. I've been working on this particular game since July, the end of July, so I've got quite a bit set up. If y'all want me to go through each of those, feel free to ask. I don't plan on doing so unless asked. So basically, what ends up happening is each of these options here are shown here, and you can select it, and then it takes you to the code and tells and shows the story. And then, because I have down here, go back to Fight Choice, but the Hide Reuse is used, Stomp is no longer allowed, so instead we have to either slap or shove this person. And so it takes you to the next portion, and so on and so forth. That's the general gist of how it works. You make choices, and then the code tells you what happens. I'm mostly going to be quiet during this. This is mostly so that I can code. That's why I have the lovely lo-fi playing in the background for you guys. Feel free to listen in. But I am going to get started. Okay. Thank you. Oh. See here, I've got to consider whether I actually need that page break or whether I can continue writing. The general consensus is you don't want more than, I'd say, about 400 words a page, if that. That's about 3 to 5 paragraphs. You can get away with longer pages, but generally, they just don't look good, you know? I'll leave it in. I think about it. This is already a charisma check. To just even be able to do this. That's the behavior. Good behavior. To the charisma, right? I mean, yeah, might as well. Can't hurt none. Oh shit, I forgot how to add things to things. Oh, it's not bad. It's set, of course. Thank you. Connecticut, but combination of etiquette and breeding. What's it called? Google Thesaurus to the rescue. 2 seconds. Decorum. Check who is there. Pulling up a character list right now. I'm assuming Zhu will be good. Section done. Okay. Just plus low. Wait. Oh, I'm just gonna roll them down. Right, okay, so this